Hi there, it's Marlene Hillema from ImageMaven.com. This video is a quick follow-up to the one I made on the Lumix G9 burst modes. And in it, I talk about all the numbers associated with each burst mode, whether it uses electronic or mechanical shutter. All right, let's get into it. After my last video on the burst modes, I got this question from a reader, and he said, I know we can do a 12 frame per second burst mode with mechanical shutter in 20 megapixels and 20 frames per second with the autofocus continuous with electronic shutter, but 20 frames per second and 60 frames per second? That's crazy. And what image size can we have with SH1 and SH2? In fact, I would like to know every image size for each burst mode before buying this camera. Let's look at the Lumix G9 burst modes by the numbers. The Lumix G9 is capable of even shooting large JPEGs and also RAW files in the super high speed burst modes. Yes, you heard that right. Now there are some limitations, of course, but they are easy to work around. With large sizes and ultra high burst modes, you're sure to fill up your memory card fast. And now I know why they included two memory card slots in this camera. Here's the chart that's right out of the Lumix G9 camera owner's manual. And now you can download the PDF of the expanded owner's manual from the Panasonic website. I'll also put that link in the video description below. There are also burst mode charts in the hard copy of the owner's manual that comes with the camera. In my English version, that's on page 48 and 114. Let's look at the numbers in this chart. Let's start on the right side with the low speed burst modes. So you can get 2 frames per second whether using the mechanical shutter or the electronic shutter at low speed. If you want to use the middle speed, you can get up to 7 frames per second. And the high speed has 12 frames per second or 9 frames per second in both the electronic and the mechanical shutter. So when the focus mode is set to autofocus single shot or manual focus, you get more frames per second. You can get the 12. When the focus mode is set to autofocus flexible or autofocus continuous, you get 9 frames per second. Now that's probably good enough for most of the things you're going to be shooting. I think 12 frames per second is plenty for what I use. However, it gets better. So when you're in the super high speed 1 mode or the super high speed 1 pre-burst, you can get up to 20 frames per second, but that is only with the electronic shutter. And in the SH2 mode, you can get up to 60 frames per second when using the autofocus single shot or manual focus, and 20 frames per second using the autofocus flexible or autofocus continuous. So basically, if you're shooting an autofocus flexible or continuous, you are limited to 20 frames per second in the SH2 and SH1 burst modes. However, personally, I use the autofocus single shot most of the time, even when shooting sports, because I typically have very good depth of field because I'm using a wide angle lens, my Lumix 7-14mm. Couple of more things to keep in mind. There are maximum amounts of captures you can do per burst mode. Now, with or without RAW files using the super high speed 1 and super high speed 2 modes, it's 50 images in one burst. And that's the maximum. However, in the low, medium, and high speed burst modes, with RAW files, you can capture 60 or more images at a time during one burst. And without RAW files, like shooting JPEGs, you can do 600 or more. Now, keep in mind that the burst speed will become slower halfway through your capture because some of those images are already starting to load into the card. However, pictures can be taken until the capacity of the card becomes full. Now, seeing the numbers is one thing, but how do these burst modes translate to your photography practice? Well, as mentioned, I shoot in autofocus single shot mode most of the time, even with sports and action, because the autofocus on the G9 is so fast that I don't have too many situations where I miss focus on a shot in one of my burst sequences. If the focus locks on in shot 1, it will still be locked on in the last photo of my sequence. Now, if you're shooting in autofocus flexible mode or autofocus continuous, then the 20 frames per second might seem limiting. But really, there aren't many situations that I personally find myself shooting in where I need more than 20 frames per second. And if you're averse to using the electronic shutter because of the distortion it may cause, then shoot using the mechanical shutter at 12 frames per second and you'll be covered for most of your shooting situations. Mechanical versus electronic shutter. When a moving subject is recorded using the electronic shutter, the subject may appear distorted. You can find that on page 199 of the large PDF of the owner's manual. Now, in my experience, the distortion hasn't been a problem so far. Because I shoot skateboarding mostly with the 7-14mm lens, I expect a fair degree of optical distortion anyhow. But I will do some tests, and you should too. Here are some other practical considerations. Upon reviewing my skateboarding action photos in Lightroom, I noticed that many of the photos were so close in composition and content that I didn't really need 60 frames per second to capture the decisive moment. When shooting faster sports, such as motor racing, or capturing other ultra-high-speed subjects, you may indeed need 60 frames per second, but I'm very happy with 20 frames per second. And at 20 frames per second, the files take up a third of the memory card and hard drive space than those shot at 60 frames per second, because there are less files. Now, you must keep in mind there is a bit of time lag when the photos are being dumped into the memory card, so make sure you get the fastest memory cards available to speed up that writing process. However, even at that, you will likely still have to wait several seconds for the writing, because imagine there are perhaps 60 frames per second, and those files are full-size RAW or full-size JPEG. They're huge, and each one of those files needs to be dumped into the memory card. So this process is not instantaneous. But as mentioned, you will likely fill up both of these memory cards quickly if you shoot SH2 and large JPEG or RAW files if you're on a big photo shoot, so take lots of memory cards with you. Thank you so much for watching, and if you'd like to learn more about digital photography, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell notification so you don't miss any of my future videos. See you next time.